Morning everyone. In this video we are going to learn some important rules of trigonometric ratios through hexagon. So this video very helpful to 10th class students. See what is here some important rules of trigonometric ratios means. The first one is product here in the sense that if we consider one trigonometric ratio tan theta, how can we write the tan theta in product of other two trigonometric ratios? How can we write sine theta in the product of other two trigonometric ratios like quotient or ratio? That means if we consider one trigonometric ratio secant theta, how can we write that secant theta in terms of other two trigonometric ratios as quotient? Like the same way complementary angles of trigonometric ratios. Complementary angles of trigonometric ratios are nothing but what? Sine 90 minus theta equal to cos theta, cos 90 minus theta equal to sine theta. So that all, how can we write through this hexagon? That all we can learn is in this video, like identities, reciprocals, that all we will discuss in this video. See, what are the trigonometric ratios we have? Sine theta, let us consider the angle as theta, sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, secant theta, cosecant theta. Totally we have 6 trigonometric ratios. First we have to write that 6 trigonometric ratios in the order of horizontal lines. See, first I want to write here sine theta. Here sine theta, here cos theta. This is first horizontal line. Now this is the diagonal. You want to consider this as the horizontal line. So sine theta, cos theta, then after tan theta and cot theta. Tan theta and cot theta. Next, secant theta, cosecant theta. So you have to consider these all trigonometric ratios are the vertices of this hexagon. Sine theta, cos theta. Tan theta, cot theta. Secant theta, cosecant theta. Okay? So like that you have to assume. First, product. See, product here. How can we write one trigonometric ratio in terms of product of other two trigonometric ratios? I want to consider first the sine theta. So sine theta I want to write as this very simple through this hexagon. Sine theta can be written as product of tan theta and cos theta. Sine theta can be written as tan theta and cos theta product. Tan theta into cos theta. Simply we can write, if you want sin theta means simply you have to write sin theta before ratio, sin theta after ratio, tan theta, cos theta. So if you want to generalize this, then we get sin theta itself, tan theta into cos theta. Tan theta can be written as what? Sin theta by cos theta, sin theta by cos theta into cos theta. So cos theta get cancelled, then write sin theta. Tan theta into cos theta is nothing but sin theta. So we can write sin theta as tan theta into cos theta before value and after value. Now I want cos theta in terms of product of other two trigonometric ratios. Cos theta is equal to, so cos theta one means write before value and after value. Before ratio sin theta, after ratio cot theta. Next I want cot theta. Cot theta can be written as cos theta into cosecant theta. Cos theta into cosecant theta. Now I want the cosecant theta. Cosecant theta can be written as cot theta into secant theta. Cot theta into secant theta. Now I want secant theta. Secant theta is equal to cosecant theta into tan theta. Cosecant theta into tan theta. Now I want tan theta. Tan theta is equal to secant theta into sin theta. Secant theta into sin theta. So, if you want to write one trigonometric ratio in terms of product of other two trigonometric ratios through hexagon, you can write like this. Sin theta is nothing but tan theta into cos theta. Cos theta equal to sin theta into cot theta. Like that, you can write all the trigonometric ratios. Here the trick is, if you want to select any one trigonometric ratio, so then if you want to write the trigonometric ratio as product of other two trigonometric ratios, means simply you have to write before ratio and after ratio. I want to select cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is nothing but before one is cot theta, after one is secant theta. Cosecant theta can be written as cot theta into secant theta. Like that, you can write all the trigonometric ratios. Okay, next, see quotient or ratio. Quotient or ratio. That means how we can write one trigonometric ratio in terms of quotient of other two trigonometric ratios. See, I want to write tan theta. So simply tan theta is nothing but what? Sin theta by cos theta. No, tan theta equal to sin theta by cos theta. So how to write the values after that trigonometric ratio? Want to sin theta means cos theta by cot theta. Cos theta means cot theta by cosecant theta, like that. See, sin theta is equal. First I want to write as anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. Clockwise. Next I want to write anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. This is clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. First see clockwise direction. I want to write sin theta. It is very simple to write sin theta. Quotient of other two trigonometric ratios is nothing but cos theta by cot theta. Cos theta by cot theta. See, it is correct or not? First we have to verify. Cos theta by cot theta. Cos theta by cot theta can be written as cos theta by sin theta. Cot theta can be written as cos theta by sin theta. This goes to numerator. Cos theta into sin theta by cos theta. Cos theta get cancelled. What we get? Sin theta. So sin theta can be written as cos theta by cot theta. Like that. Want to write cos theta. So clockwise direction. Cot theta by cosecant theta. Cot theta by cosecant theta. Next, cot theta. Cot theta can be written as cosecant theta by secant theta. Cosecant theta by secant theta. Next I want secant theta. Secant theta is equal to tan theta by sin theta. Here I missed cosecant theta. No? Cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is equal to secant theta by tan theta. Secant theta. Secant theta is equal to tan theta by sin theta. Tan theta by sin theta. Now tan theta is equal to sin theta by after two ratios. Sin theta by cos theta. Like that we can write all trigonometric ratios. Sin theta equal to cos theta by cot theta. It is very simple to write. If you want to write sin theta in terms of quotient of other two trigonometric ratios, means how to write after two trigonometric ratios. Sin theta after two, cos theta, cot theta in clockwise direction. So you can write like that. So anti-clockwise direction, like this. Anti-clockwise direction. I want to start from sin theta itself. Sin theta can be written as tan theta by secant theta. Once we have to check it is correct or not. Tan theta by secant theta. So tan theta can be written as sin theta by cos theta. No? It is divided by secant theta is nothing but 1 by cos theta. Cos theta get cancelled. Then what we got? Sin theta by 1 is nothing but what? Sin theta. So correct one. So anti-clockwise direction. How we can write sin theta equal to tan theta by secant theta. Next one, tan theta. Tan theta can be written as secant theta by cosecant theta. Secant theta by cosecant theta. Next one. Secant theta. Secant theta is equal to cosecant theta by cot theta. Cosecant theta by cot theta. Next, cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is equal to cot theta by cos theta. Cot theta by cos theta. Next, I want to write cot theta. Cot theta is equal to cos theta by sin theta. Next, what? Cos theta. Cos theta can be written as sin theta by tan theta. like that we can write. So this is a trigonometric ratio is equal to product of two trigonometric ratios, and which is the trigonometric ratio is equal to quotient of other two trigonometric ratios. So the product and quotient. Next we see complementary ratios of complementary angles of trigonometric ratios. Complementary angles. Angles of trigonometric ratios. So theta under 90 minus theta are called the complementary angles. Theta under 90 minus theta are called the complementary angles. See here, the trick is very simple. So see only horizontal lines. Here you have to consider this diagonal also as a horizontal line. So sin theta, cos theta, one horizontal line. Tan theta, cot theta as vertices, one horizontal line. Secant theta, cosecant theta as vertices, one horizontal line. See, from this, sin 90 minus theta. Sin 90 minus theta. This want to write as sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. Only horizontal line. Sin 90 minus theta equal to cos theta. Cos 90 minus theta equal to sin theta. Reverse. Cos 90 minus theta equal to sin theta. Next, here horizontal line itself. Tan 90 minus theta is equal to cot theta. Again, cot 90 minus theta equal to tan theta. Cot 90 minus theta equal to tan theta. Similarly, secant 90 minus theta equal to cosecant theta. Secant 90 minus theta equal to cosecant theta. Cosecant 90 minus theta equal to secant theta. So here you have to consider the trick as horizontal lines. Horizontal line segments. So by that we can write all the trigonometric ratios. All the complementary angles of all the trigonometric ratios by horizontal lines we can write. Okay. Next, identities. Before identities, I will say reciprocals. So already we know reciprocal ratios. Reciprocal ratios are what? Sin theta and cosecant theta are reciprocal. Tan theta, cot theta are reciprocal. Secant theta, cos theta are the reciprocal. See how can we write? Simply means that. Right, draw diagonals. We only join the vertices, opposite vertices. It has more than three diagonals. It has more than three diagonals. I want to join only the vertices. Sin theta, cosecant theta, secant theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta. This is only the reciprocal. So the product of two reciprocal terms is always equal to 1. So that sin theta, the diagonal opposite cosecant theta 1, secant theta cos theta into secant theta is equal to 1, tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. These are the reciprocal ratios. Okay, this is complementary angles of trigonometric ratios. With the horizontal lines we can write easily. Next, very important one is identities of trigonometric identities. See, trigonometric identities. So sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So here we have in each and every trigonometric ratio 1 is there. So I want to write keep that one as in center point. Here if you observe, so many triangles are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have here 6 triangles. See, I want to check only, I want to take the triangles only these. That means this is one triangle I will take. And I want to remove this triangle. Then after I will take this triangle. Remove this triangle. Then after you can take this triangle. Okay, only if you observe, only same symbol having here, like this. And clockwise direction, we have a symbol, clockwise direction. So how can we write trigonometric ratio? See, start from here, sine square theta. So here in trigonometric ratios, the common point is each and every trigonometric ratio has square and one also. In trigonometric ratios, one also is there. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Start from here. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Clockwise direction. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Start from here. Sine square theta cos square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Next. Second. Start from here. Tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta. From here you have to start and end here. Tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta. Next, from here 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosecant square theta. 1 plus cos square theta equal to cosecant square theta. Start from here, sine square theta plus cos square theta, it will end here, equal to 1. Next, from here, start here, tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta. Again, start from here onwards, because it starts here onwards. 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosecant square theta, okay? This is clockwise direction. Now see, anti-clockwise direction. When we are telling in clockwise direction, you have to use the symbol here plus. Anti-clockwise direction is you have to use the symbol minus here. Here for this trick, clockwise direction. Clockwise direction like this. 1 plus, sorry, here we have to use the symbol minus. Here starts from 1. 1 minus cos square theta equal to sine square theta. 1 minus cos square theta equal to sine square theta. From this we can write 1 is equal to sine square theta plus cos square theta like that. So next, second one. Secant square theta minus 1. Secant square theta minus 1 is equal to tan square theta. And third one, cosecant square theta minus cos square theta is equal to 1. Cosecant square theta minus cos square theta equal to 1. So like this we can write the trigonometric ratios, trigonometric identities through this hexagon. So I hope you understand this video in a good manner. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for getting more videos. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.